Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week, we're on the Olympic Peninsula in Washington, fishing winter steelhead with guide Rich Underwood. If you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. We're deep in the Olympic Peninsula inside Quinault tribal lands following our guide, Rich Underwood, to a special section of the Quinault River.
Yeehaw! Go fishing!
So we're going to the Quinault River. This is a secret hole. You've never been here before, have you?
I haven't, no. This is a new one.
We're out in the middle of nowhere here on the Olympic Peninsula in the Quinault River with Rich. So that's a good thing.
Oh yeah, it's a fun day.
There's a log jam, so boats can't get down it. So we're in a spot that's blocked and pinched off on both below and above. So We've got this stretch to ourselves.
Alright. So what are the conditions like?
A couple days ago we got a little bump in rain and the water came up a little, but now it's dropping perfect. So it should be a good day. Your best ally is time in the water, so usually it's just pretty much me and Steve fishing today and Rich running the boat and fishing a little bit, but so I probably go a little excessive on rods, but just getting all the lead snapped on, and we're just running quarters here because a lot of times we're fishing towards the bank and we're not in the deepest of water, so just small leads are more than adequate. So today we're going to be starting out the morning with running double bead setups. We're going to either run B&R beads or these new Oregon tackle beads. These are infused with Pro Cure. Both are a great option. They all have their days. As far as the weights go, what we're running is the Poochie or P-Line Dragon Balls. They're a coated steel weight, and they bounce along the bottom really good. You don't get hung up a lot with them.
Yeah, we're down here just above the midsection on the Quinault, just above Cook Creek. They call Cook Creek, and we're below Camp 7. A lot of the guides right now are above us, so we had to push this road in. About a month ago wasn't accessible, but now it is, and we've got probably about 5 miles of water we're gonna fish today. A little variation of everything, a little bit of float fishing, bobber dogging, maybe some spoon fishing, and probably use mainly soft beads this time of the year. I like to use get away from the baits as much as possible, because we're getting into the wild run now, and most of it's hook and release, so I'd kind of refrain from using a little bit more bait than I usually do. So anyhow, we'll see how it goes. Should be a real good day. Weather wise looks really good. Forecast calling for a lot of sunshine. Vitamin D is what we need.
I give you shrimp. I'm using my favorite. You go to
we're here. Being on the coastal river, them fish, they eat a lot of that shrimp, and even I can't remember the name of that small shrimp they use or eat out there in the ocean. Plankton. Well, they eat plankton and eat the small shrimp. So they're so accustomed to that. And then you get that scent right up here, and it's like, oh yeah, there we go. Well, today, the 16th, March 16th, we're in the wild fish phase of our management. Yesterday was hatchery origin, and so we managed for our hatchery fish, and that's consistent with our broodstock program we have, and I talked about that on one of the episodes. But it's important to note that, because we're transitioning now to the wild stock, so we're kind of at the in an area now where there is predominantly wild fish, so that's kind of nice, because we always want our hatchery production to produce
which we know it does consistently year in, year out. But you know, we've been concerned about our wild stock as of lately, you know, due to unforeseen things that we have no control of. You know, one is climate change and how that's affected the ocean. Watch that snag right there, Steve. So, you know, we, bummer. Should have told you a second earlier.
Yeah, sorry.
Ah, bummer. But anyway, yeah, our hatchery production, it has done quite well this year. We've got our egg take, we've got everything we needed this year. So, oh, bummer. So we're really looking forward to our wild stock run this year. And lately, you know, in the last couple of weeks, our encounters with the wild fish that I noticed have gone up tremendously. So, you know, I think it's just a late run, you know, the later run this year. And I think that's indicative of all the coastal streams, coastal rivers. So I'm just pleased to see all these wild fish coming back. And there's some big, geez, there was some big spawners we caught already. 18-pound spawner the other day. Good grief. Imagine that thing in its prime, probably 20, 23 pounds. But
there we go.
Oh, nice, there's a fish. Oh, nice, big one too, Steve. Right next to that.
That didn't take long.
No.
First cast just loaded it up.
While fishing the Quinault River, stay at the Quinault River Inn in Amanda Park. Visit QuinaultRiverInn.com. Welcome back to the Quinault River. I'm Justin Wolf. It's a cold morning, but Steve Lynch loaded up a B&R soft bead with Anna's Bloody Tuna Super Gel and enticed our first fish of the morning to bite. We're with Quinault Nation guide, Rich Underwood.
Jason, you gonna get that net ready?
Oh yeah, it looks like another one of them little wild ones.
Hey, Rich,
yeah. Do you have a heater for this net?
Yeah, I'm gonna drop down.
Yeah, here we go.
Sliding down. You ready, Jason? It's gonna happen. Oh, that's another one of them spawners. See that? That's good to see. Boy, they're super aggressive. Well, those things ain't very old. There. Oh, look at that. Yeah. Yeah, I'd like to go back and spawn again. You're running upstream. There you go, Steve. You got it. There we go. Oh, nice. Yeah, it's away. That's a good one there.
Thank you, Lord, man. Peace out with another.
This one looks like it's already done its thing. I don't know if it's a wild or a hatchery yet. I haven't looked, but regardless, we're probably going to let this one go.
First cast after the snag.
That one's a clip fish, but it's mended. It's already done its thing, so we're going to go ahead and let that one go. Good job, Steve.
Thank you, Lord, man. Okay, please have another. Woohoo! Right on. Well, Rich, that didn't take off.
No, that worked out well.
That just goes to show, you know, even a hatchery fish, they spawn on the river. These ones are just, you know, like I said, these fish are just one cycle away from being a true wild fish.
Yeah,
they're one cycle away. See, these fish, they originated, the original gene pool that we took out of the system to supplement this run happened back in the late 50s, early 60s, and it really transpired. Like prior to USB Washington, we were already raising quite a few hatchery steelhead. And what we were taking at that time, we were taking all the biggest and the meanest ones, both female and male. And these are the ones that are the offspring of those, that gene pool that we took out and added to our enhancement program. So every year these things come back, and you know, they came from that original fish back in the late 50s to today, which is, like I said, one cycle away from being a true wild. If that thing, if we didn't take it out of the system, it would have came back anyway. And so we release those fish, especially these spawners, release them, because they may come back two or three times. And, you know, by the second or third time, these things are 23, 24 pounds. And so that's what we like to see.
It's beautifully clear up here. It's going to be a really nice day, but this morning it is cold. It's, when we were pulling in here, it was mid-20s, so it was a chappy one.
Yeah, so when that bobber goes down, Steve, generally at that shallow, when the bobber goes down, that fish will be already jumping. You would know it was a fish.
Yeah
probably nine. Okay, switch sides real quick. Yeah, I expect them to be next to that gravel, right on the inside part of that. Don't fish the outside seam, that's a little bit fast. We want to put it right on the inside in that slow stuff. Oh. That's all right, Steve. Go ahead and leave it right there. You're okay. Jason, get in there a little bit further. There we go. Okay. Yeah, it's a little lazy spot. See, we're in a fast current, and fish are like us. We're kind of lazy, you know, sometimes, and like to take shortcuts, not exert a whole lot of energy in doing things. So that's what the fish do. They stay in that softer water. Even though it's about maybe 2 feet deep in there, they're going to hang in there. You know, there's a lot of break in the water, and of course the sun ain't out yet. They feel comfortable, they feel safe there. Otherwise, you know, we've got predators, we've got eagles around here that probably catch them once in a while.
I like to use a one for 14, size 16, 14 mil soft beads. But for the 20 mil and above, I use a 1/0 and a 2/0 hook, and I use the wide gap hooks. Reason being, I think when we release our hatchery releases our little smolts. If we got too small of hooks, well, you're going to catch all them little smolts. But I always encourage people to use a bigger hook this time of the year. Besides, if you're here, this March Madness, if you're here to catch that big steelhead, you know, March, everybody knew that if you're on a Quinault in March, you're fishing for some large steelhead, 20 plus pounders, you know, an occasional 30 plus pounder here on a lower Quinault. So it's better to use a 2/0 hook and catch a 25, 30 pounder versus a number four or number two. Break them things right off. Oh, dang it, you break me off.
We're fishing for winter steelhead on the Quinault River with guide Rich Underwood. It's going to be a beautiful sunny day, but the morning is cold, so Rich has decided to make a run down to a section of river that will catch the first morning rays of sunlight. And in a slightly stained water, larger beads are on the menu.
Here on the Quinault, you know, we've got a little bit of off color. It's been this way since about mid-December, after the first big rain we had. So I always upgrade. When I upgraded, I use a 20 mil soft bead, and those have been pretty productive over the years. So it's kind of hard to get away from using 20 mils. I know some people use 14 and 16 mil beads, but they do okay. But again, it goes back to that hook size. You know, I think that if you put too big of a hook on a smaller bead, it takes away the action of that bead. And so the bigger the bead, the bigger the hook. And, you know, fishing on the Quinault, you got a larger fish that we're targeting. So the anticipation of catching a 30-pounder, you know, you won't want to have a number four hook on and be battling a big 30-pound steelhead, which is kind of what everybody dreams of.
Retie some of these oopsies and running a 20 millimeter on top and a 16 millimeter bead on the bottom. These are the 16 millimeter, yes. With the 20 millimeter, I'll tie the 16 millimeter off the bend of the hook. I just run a cinch knot. Like that. Oh, hooked up over there, way against the other bank there, and Haven't seen him yet, but he feels like a decent fish. Might be the one I broke off a little bit ago. Might have the bead in its mouth.
Oh, look at that. Oh, gee, wait, it slipped right up.
What do you say?
They want to go, they want to go.
That fish hit the mottled pink color. I lost the bead in the during the fight, so I'm just going to tie another one on here real quick, and we'll get back out and get another one.
It's my favorite steelhead scent, Anisporty tuna.
Character lure out there, and while Jason's fishing that inside seam, I'm going to put this one right down the middle of the slot, so we'll probably get that 20 pounder with this guy. Oh, that's a pretty plug. Good.
Right on!
Oh, little guy.
You guys better know, guy.
Oh, I know, right? We didn't even drop down 10 feet. Didn't even drop 10 feet. That plug just got down and started working. I just comment how that felt. I was thinking, man, that thing feels really good down there. And then, bam, 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 there he is. Oh, that's a little guy. Just got down there, yeah. That combination of that scent and that color plug, Steve. There you go. Got him, buddy?
No.
That's a character plug made by Carlos. I want to thank Carlos personally for his contribution. You know, he helped me out there when I was first diagnosed with cancer. He built one of those, and geez, the fellas that bidded for it did a wonderful job. And I really want to thank Carlos for his contribution. Yep. And these things, oh, that's a beautiful thing right there.
Yep. I shortened my stopper quite a bit.
Oh, you did? That's
yes, sir. I got tired of losing bottom bead, baby.
All right. Surprising you made it through over that tree.
Nice fish.
I'm going to slide down on it. There we go.
Oh. Nice fish.
Welcome back to the Quinault River, where Steve Lynch has another winter steelhead hooked up on a B&R soft bead coated with Anna's Bloody Tuna Super Gel.
Fish.
Got it for you. Now we're just going to have to unbutton it because it's a nice fish.
This one's already spawned, so we're going to release it.
There we go. Oh, yeah. Gone.
Yes, sir.
Gone. And it's the new burr bead made by B&R. This one here is called Lucky. And so we're going to put this one back on there in hopes of recapturing one.
Right?
It was lucky. Let's put that on the back of your hook and slide it. There you go.
That one hit the big bead. Hit the 20 millimeter. That one looks like a hatchery. Steve's been looking for one to take home and eat.
There's your Sandy River 20.
Not the Sandy River 15.
That's the least.
Oh, okay. He's probably got a tag in it. You know, more than likely got a tag. So he's a tag fish. And they're not all clipped. That's what we mean by this clip. Yeah.
They didn't get the whole out of post. They just took a sleeve of it.
But, you know, it's a little tiny one anyway. It's something we want to take out of the system. We don't want too little of fish.
So here on the Quinault, we're allowed to keep one steelhead. We're, you know, mid-March. That regulation came out in December. Regulation was a three fish limit. And then in mid-February, went down to a two fish limit. And so now we're in mid-March. Now we're, each angler can keep one fish. So, you know, the Quinault Indian Nation raises almost 3 million fish annually, salmon and steelhead, combined with the three hatchery system, the three hatcheries that we manage, and we co-manage one of the hatcheries, Cook Creek. So anyway, we've got an abundance of steelhead. So, and that one there was a smaller fish. So one of the good eaters, you know. I don't like to keep the big ones. You know, I think those ones, you know, they lose their flavor and all that stuff. So it's best to take them little ones out.
Well, Steve's caught so many fish that he put the rod down, so I picked it up. Guess what? I hooked one.
And it's buddy tuna.
And it's buddy tuna. And too much of it.
I'll lose it.
I'll loosen the drag a little bit. I think bottom line is it's nice and sunny and warm, and we're all taking our coats off, and the fish are feeling like biting a little more now. So I think it's going to be a good afternoon. All right, I'm going to swing him around, and he's going to come right in the net. Here we go. Yeah. So, Rich, all right, if somebody wanted to come up here and do this, I mean, what do? They call you?
Yeah, or? They give me a call, and, you know, I work with other guides. I'm fully booked now, but, you know, I work with a lot of credible guides and a lot of up-and-comers, too. I really appreciate those young guides.
I mean, it's a beautiful river. It's one of your favorite rivers, right, Jason?
Oh, without question.
I mean, Jason's always looking for an excuse to come here.
Yep, found one.
So, yeah, you want to do a great fishing trip, you just give Rich a call and get up here to the Quinault. This is really awesome.
See you later, fish.
And that's not even a very big one, right, Rich? I mean, that's just a medium-sized, good quality fish. Hey everybody, thanks for watching today's episode. And be sure to stop by the Angler West store in Woodland, Washington. I'm sure we can help you catch more fish. And remember, without the sponsors, there is no show. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.